Hey, folks, here we are on the Nylon Swamp.
And I'm just going to dial in some of our places to share our feed.
You are the exclusive group of people who know that we came on 12 seconds late tonight. Don't tell. There's something familiar to start the evening off. I'm now the city of New Orleans. Whoops, that's the wrong key. I can't sing
it in
that key.
Oops, we're left over from the practicing. Hi, Don Martucci. Thanks for joining us.
Riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central, Monday morning rail. 15 cars, 15 restless riders, 3 conductors, 25 sacks of mail. All along the southbound Odyssey, the train pulls out from Kankakee, rolls along past houses, farms, and fields, passing trains that have no names. Railroads full of black men in the graves of the rusted automobile. Good morning, America, how are you? Don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train they call the city. I've been gone 500 miles when the day is done, dealing card games with the old men in the club car. Penny a point, ain't no one keeping score. Pass the paper bag that holds the bottle. Feel the wheels rumbling neath the floor. And the sons of Pullman porters and the sons of engineers ride their father's magic carpet made of steel. Mothers with their babes asleep are rocking to the gentle beat, and the rhythm of the rails is all they feel. Good morning, America, how are you? Don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train they call the city of New Orleans. I've been gone 500 miles when the day is done.
Take it, darling.
Mm-hmm. Nighttime on the city of New Orleans, changing cars in Memphis, Tennessee. Halfway home, we'll be there by morning. Through the Mississippi darkness, rolling down to the sea. But all the towns and people seem to fade into a bad dream, and the steel rail still ain't heard the news. The conductor sings the songs again. Passengers will please refrain. This train got the disappearing railroad blues. Good night, America, how are you? Don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train they call the city of New Orleans. Be gone 500 miles when the day is done.
There she goes. Pretty soon you can't hear the train. So you know your ears down to the track.
Nice.
You hear it pumping. That's the train. About to putting your ear down to the rail. Don't do that at home.
No, not a safe thing to do. Let's see. Hi, Marilyn Barton and John T. Walsh Jr. Thanks for joining us. And I see Joe Giglio just signed on. And boy, did we enjoy his show this afternoon.
Hello, Joe.
Yeah, you can check Joe Giglio out at 2 o'clock on Sundays on Facebook, a live show. And he was kind enough to share a link to our show tonight, too. So thank you, Joe.
So, we're still in these bars.
We are. Always in these bars.
1, 2, 3, 4.
It's so hard to take it all when you can't raise a smile. When singing your old songs wears you down just like a mile. We rode along through the 7 winters where through mean times and good we sang away our cares. And I'm still in these bars, and I'm still on the run, still singing songs, and I'm still having my fun. Late at night, we would end up in some dive, talking over the good times until the morning light. Laughing over the time we got lost out in the snow. How we picked up the beat, found the way to go. And I'm still in these bars, and I'm still on the run, still singing having my fun.
like I called all my shots, and like you know all my thoughts. Well, you must know a lot. Still I wish we could sing together again, standing side by side like we were still old friends. And I'm still in these bars, and I'm still on the run, still singing my songs, and I'm still having my fun. Next, we have a song written by
Stephen Gillette,
Steve
and
Gillette.
Thomas Campbell.
And Thomas Campbell, and this is called Darcy Farrow. It's a song that I guess a lot of people think is a folk song when they hear it, and I think it comes from that time when a lot of folk singers in the late '60s and early '70s were writing fake folk songs. I wrote a couple of fake folk songs.
This is one of Judy's favorites too. I want to say hi to Blaze, who joined us. Hey, Blaze. If you are watching, just drop us a line so we know you're there.
I guess the real definition of a folk song is we don't really know who wrote it, because usually it's passed through several hands, which I know because of the way that I forget lyrics and make them up as I go sometimes. I can see how people change songs quite a bit over the years.
Yeah,
probably. Okay, here we go. My error. I'm doing that. That's the second time I did that to you tonight. Where are the keys? Where are the keys?
Okay. All right, let's try that again.
One, two, three, four. Where the walker runs down to the Carson Valley Plain, there lived a maiden, Darcy Farrow was her name. The daughter of old Dundee, and a fair one was she, the sweetest flower that bloomed o'er the range. Her voice was as sweet as the sugar candy, her touch was as soft as a bed of goose down. Her eyes shone bright like the pretty lights that shine in the night out of Yarrington town. She was courted by young Vandermeer, and quite handsome was he, as I hear. He brought her silver rings and lacy things. She promised to wed before the snows fell that year. Ah, but her pony did stumble and she did fall. Her dying touched the hearts of us one and all. Young Vandy in his pain put a bullet through his brain. They buried them together as the snows began to fall. Thank you.
They sing of Darcy Farrow, where the Truckee runs through. They sing of her beauty in Virginia City, too. At dusty sundown, to her name they drink around. And to young Vandy, whose love was true. Where the Walker runs down to the Carson Valley Plain, there lived a maiden, Darcy Farrow was her name. Daughter of old Dundee, and a fair one was she, and the sweetest flower that bloomed for the range.
Darcy Farrow. Whew. Yeah, I heard that song from Ian and Sylvia, and I was one of their biggest, hugest fans. I saw them several times, and
I've heard other rumors too.
Yeah, it's true. I had a crush on Sylvia. I admit. great. So, and this is a song written by Sylvia. It was done as it was a hit record by a group called We Five, who never made another record again, which I think is probably fortunate because they just changed the song so utterly that when I heard the real You Were On My Mind, I said, oh, that's a good song. And I loved the way Ian played acoustic. He played a great acoustic rhythm guitar, and he was not really, you know, known as a great guitar player, but he's pretty good on that. I believe he's playing 12 string, and he does that. I have a couple of his little chops. Here we go.
Thank you.
soft-hearted woman with a taste for the bottle. I scorned her and drove her away. She just sits there drinking, drinking and dreaming of her North Country so far away. The first time I saw her by the banks of my river, she looked like an angel's pure. My heart sprouted wings as it struggled beside her, and the oaths of young lovers we swore. Through the green days of summer, through the fields and the orchards we strayed. But at night in the taverns, we drank till we stumbled. Till we stumble our separate ways. As the years pass, it all seems sublime, where the river of myth meets the river of time. Is it all lost as it goes down the line, like the grain in the whiskey, like the grapes in the wine? Well, I thought she'd go north and to the land of her fathers, where the white water rushes so cold. But for her, there's one river, that's the river of whiskey, that runs through her trembling soul. She works in a tavern by the banks of my river. I won't stop, she still looks so fine. The face of a farm girl from some now distant century seemed lost in a river of time. Sometimes when I'm lonely, I walk by the river, that old northbound drifter rolls by. My eyes glimpse a bottle that floats on the water. I remember that girl with a sigh. As the years pass, it all seems sublime, where the river of myth meets the river of time. Is it all down the line, like the grain in the whiskey, like the grapes in the wine, like the grain in the whiskey, like the grapes in the wine. It's called The Grain in the Whiskey, The Grapes in the Wine. And now we've got a spectacular poem for you tonight, one that I've always loved. And I have to tell you, actually, I'm not going to be using it anymore. Oh. So I'll put it away and I'll come back and I'll tell you about all about it.
All right, well, while you're doing that, I want to say hi to Aunt Marilyn. Thank you, Aunt Marilyn. I just see your comment there. She says, we look and sound good. I hope that her eyesight and her hearing is okay. No, it's really good to see you joining us tonight. Hi, Uncle Joe.
Yeah. So, you know, I guess for a lot of the folks my age, and even younger, and even older, you may have had to memorize a Robert Frost poem in school. I know I did, and you know, it's not something I particularly wanted to do, although I was glad after I memorized it. And I think it was, I'm sure it was Whose Woods These Are. I think I know his house is in the suburbs, though. did I say that?
No.
Oh, goodness gracious. So we're talking about Robert Frost. And Frost has been so, for so many years, was so ubiquitous across America that his poems were anthologized in every anthology. Every kid had to memorize a Robert Frost poem. I guess in some ways, you know, he seemed to never say anything particularly controversial until you started looking carefully and you found out that a lot of these sweet little poems had little things in them, sometimes in places that were sort of interesting. And I know that I sort of tired of Frost a little bit and made cracks about him when I first became an English major. I developed a profound respect for Robert Frost. I can't say too much. In fact, as much as I love my book of 180 poems I've been reading lately, when I took out this poem and read it today, I thought to myself, geez, you know, I don't know if there's been a wordsmith writing poetry in America quite as good as Robert Frost. He still holds up. And I think you'll agree when you hear this description of birch trees by Robert Birch. And this is called Robert Birch. By Robert Frost. Frost, birch, it's all in the poem anyway, right?
This reminds me of a birch tree that used to be in our front yard, yeah. where we grew up in Ackward.
Okay. Birches by Robert Frost. When I see birches bend to left and right across the lines of straighter, darker trees, I like to think some boy's been swinging them. But swinging doesn't bend them down to stay as ice storms do. Often you must have seen them loaded with ice on a sunny winter morning after a rain. They click upon themselves as the breeze rises and turn many colored as the stir cracks and crazes their enamel. Soon, the sun's warmth makes them shed crystal shells, shattering and avalanching on the snow crust. Such heaps of broken glass to sweep away, you'd think the inner dome of heaven had fallen. They are dragged to the withered bracken by the load, and they seem not to break. Though once they are bowed for so long, they never quite right themselves. You may see their trunks arching in the woods years afterwards, trailing their leaves on the ground like girls on hands and knees that throw their hair before them over their heads to dry in the sun. But I was going to say, when truth broke in with all her matter of fact about the ice storm, I should prefer to have some boy bend them as he went out and in to fetch the cows. Some boy too far away from town to learn baseball, whose only play was what he found himself. Summer or winter, and could play alone. One by one, he subdued his father's trees by riding them down over and over again until he took the stiffness out of them. And not but one hung limp, not one was left for him to conquer. He learned all there was to learn about not launching out too soon, and so not carrying the tree away clear to the ground. He always kept his poise to the top branches, climbing carefully with the same pains you use to fill a cup up to the brim and even above the brim. Then he flung outward, feet first, with a swish, kicking his way down through the air to the ground. So was I, once myself, a swinger of birches. And so I dream of going back to be. It's when I'm weary of considerations, and life is too much like a pathless wood, where your face burns and tickles with the cobwebs broken across it, and one eye is weeping from a twig's having lashed across it open. I'd like to get away from Earth a while, and then come back to it and begin over. May no fate willfully misunderstand me and half grant what I wish and snatch me away not to return. Earth's the right place for love. I don't know where it's likely to go better. I'd like to go by climbing a birch tree. and climb black branches up a snow-white trunk toward heaven, till the tree could bear no more, but dipped its top and set me down again. That would be good, both going and coming back. One could do worse than be a swinger of birches.
Yeah, that's one of his best.
I will never cease to be moved by that
poem. Yes.
Yes, where are we? Getting another guitar out. That's
yes,
what we're doing.
Yes, another guitar. Different
guitar. Speaking of birches and woods and stuff like that, I have my song about running in the gulks. And,
running in the Shongum Mountains.
It's true. I ran in the gunks from the time I was 21 till the time I was...
You ran when you were 21?
No, when I was 29. From the time 29. I was 29, yeah. Till... I don't know what 21 is. You know why? 21 is a significant year. I did that once before and something too. I'm kind of stuck here.
Oh, yeah, you got it.
I wish they'd make cordless guitars.
Yeah.
So,
dance.
In any case... up in the gunks, so for many years I ran up in the gunks. Until I started getting lame. And then I also hurt my knees and ankles and hips too. what is wrong with this picture?
I don't know. That's not turned on. Is your amp on? Your pedal board is on.
Your
pedal board is on.
The tone got a little wrong. Oh, I see what the problem is. Got it. Okay. Get a screwdriver out and tighten that knob. That's what I wanted. Excellent.
Yes, okay.
Okay, running together. I believed in you when I was still lonely. A shadow that ran out before me. Just around the bend. I was alone, but I was feeling stronger. I found freedom and emotion and wonder. I caught up to you. We were floating painlessly, just like angels on that morning without ending. Two of us running chasing the sunlight of the mountains. The night comes from the east, so you hear us singing, shaking the night fingers from our shoulders.
Chasing the sunlight on the mountain.
Yeah, that was running together.
Yeah. Hey, Mr. Miller. Philip Miller just
joined
us.
Hey, Phil Miller, how are you, man?
Good to see you there. Blaze had great picking, Kurt.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hi, Blaze, how are you?
He's good at that picking stuff.
I picked you. So, let me see. What do we got here?
A human egg.
Ah, yeah, okay. Got it. This is what happens when you mix reggae and bluegrass together. I hear my name come spreading through the trees. My child's cold, I just can't sleep. The sky is clear, no clouds obscure the view. So a strange thing.
Okay, I just can't change it if it does.
Yeah, my string fell right off the bridge piece. And I just replaced this bridge because...
because of that.
Because of that, yeah. But the other bridge was worse because when it fell off the bridge piece, then what happened is this little saddle in there, this saddle popped out and onto the floor. And that was really no good if you think this was bad. Was at the Rosendale Street Festival. I was crawling around on the stage looking for a piece of my guitar bridge. People liked it just the same. I mean, they clapped louder for that than for the songs. But.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to end up with one more song for you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Next week, right here on 9 Mile Swamp.
Yes, and if you are in the area, in our area, we are playing a live show at Rock to Casbah in Saugerties on Friday night, the 21st, at 6:30 we start. So come on out and say hello. Thank you so much for joining us. And we will see you on the weekend. Ah, here we go. Thanks, Michael. We're so grateful you could make it. Thanks, Blaze. Yeah, this sign's for you, Joe. Sign of the end is here. Thanks, Ruthie.
Is that good, Kurt?
We're fading out.